In this video, I will show how to check a capacitor with a multimeter. I have two metal paper starting sealed single layer MGB02 capacitors with a capacity of 20 microfarads and a rated voltage of 500 volts, and one of them has failed, so now our sawmill is not working. I desoldered these capacitors from the circuit, and now we can compare. What distinguishes a functioning capacitor from a faulty one? The faulty capacitor is on the right, and the functioning one is on the left. As you can see, the faulty capacitor is noticeably swollen at the top, sides, and bottom. And this is already the first sign that it can be thrown away. But we will see what the readings will be with the multimeter and how to check its functionality. Each capacitor has the property of storing electrical energy, and accordingly, its resistance changes depending on this. So, we will take the multimeter and check the readings on these capacitors. When a capacitor is fully discharged, its resistance is zero, and as it accumulates charge, its resistance increases. In a fully charged capacitor, the resistance is infinite, which means it is equivalent to 1. First, it is necessary to set the multimeter switch to the resistance testing mode. I will set it to 20 kilo, and we will start measuring the resistance. Before checking the capacitor, it is necessary to discharge any residual voltage that remains on it. For this, we use either the multimeter probe, a screwdriver, or pliers. But it is better to use some kind of resistance, particularly an incandescent lamp, to prevent the contacts from burning. It is connected with some resistance, particularly an incandescent lamp, to prevent the contacts from burning. We will discharge the voltage and start measuring the resistance. Since the capacitor is powerful, I will first set the resistance switch on the multimeter to the 2000 kOhm position. After that, we will connect the probes of the multimeter to the capacitor and check its readings. As you can see, the resistance starts to increase very gradually and slowly. It will continue to steadily rise until the capacitor is fully and completely charged, at which precise point the resistance will equal that of a short-circuited capacitor. The resistance across the capacitor increases because the internal power source is actively and continuously supplying energy to the capacitor. Here, the capacitor is charged and the resistance is infinite. Now we can check what voltage this capacitor has stored. To do this, we switch the multimeter to measure direct voltage at a maximum of 20 volts and check what current is currently on the capacitor. As you can see, it is currently 0.38 volts and the voltage is dropping slightly because it is now supplying its voltage to the multimeter. Thus, we can conclude that this capacitor is completely functional and can be used further. Now let's see how a faulty capacitor behaves. We will connect the multimeter probes to the terminals of the capacitor. As you can see, the resistance is zero, meaning the circuit is completely broken and it does not store electrical energy, regardless of the position of the probes. Now let's check what voltage it can accumulate during this specific time. As we can see, there is no voltage across it, meaning it is not storing anything. Therefore, we can confidently discard it and buy another one.